remarks, and then we'll take questions from the room. If you have a question on Zoom, please use the raise my hand option. Ricky, we'll start with opening remarks following today's victory over Tigres.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think it was a really good game for the crowd. I'd say that it was a very entertaining game. You know, and credit to Tigres. You know, they come here, they made it incredibly difficult for us. They defended perhaps in a different way than we thought they would defend, which I think after our goal, 10, 15 minutes into the game, it made it a little bit difficult for us. But, you know, we've had a challenging week and the team kept working, and we said it's about a team performance, and sometimes individuals have to step up and score goals or create moments where we make saves or we block shots. And I think you saw that tonight. I think out of possession, we worked incredibly hard. We talked about being relentless, higher up the field, especially in the second half. We won the field tilt in the second half. We spoke about that at halftime. Can we get higher up the field? And I think in possession, you know, Bob come on, and one of the things we've been speaking about all week is the number 10 running in behind the spaces between the fullback and the centre back. And it's a great finish from Bob. You know, she does that all the time in training. So very, very proud of the team, you know, just incredibly proud of the way they stuck to it and worked.
Thank you for that. We'll go to questions here in the room. Alex, go ahead.
Coach, first of all, congratulations. Earlier, we used the word a monumental victory for not only for your team, but for the club. It might need a little time to sink in, but do you see it as well that way?
Look, you know, to be completely honest with you, we spoke about taking it one game at a time. You know, we've had some difficult games. We've played Kansas, who are probably one of the best teams in the league at the moment, twice back to back. And for us, it's always been about one game at a time. And we spoke about today coming out and building on the things that we've already done. And we knew that if we did that, we would cause them problems. So us, it's always one game at a time at the moment. But, you know, I said in the huddle at the end, I was incredibly proud of the group. There was moments where the emotional control got the better of us. The game got chippy and we stuck to the game plan. We stuck to the little details. And we speak about that all the time. It's always about the details. So massive game to win, but, you know, the credit goes to the players.
Speaking of your players, Coach, your line of four, very disciplined today. And my observation from afar, it's something that's continued to improve communication-wise and timing-wise. Today, some excellent tackles with that ball fouling. I imagine they've been working on that. I think that's a foundation for everything you wanted to do moving forward.
Yeah, I mean, look, you know, we've got some unbelievable players from a defensive perspective. But, you know, I think one of the things you're seeing is the work from our forwards. You know, the forwards are working incredibly hard higher up the field. And we speak a lot about building pressure and disrupting pressure. And I think you're seeing that a lot. So it helps the back line a lot. You know, they're dealing with less in 1v1 moments, and they're dealing more with perhaps longer balls so they can help each other and cover each other a little bit. But make no doubts about it, you know, we try and defend as a team higher up the field, and I think you're seeing that in the games.
One more, Coach. We saw you turn around and ask for that support from the crowd. Mm-hmm. Obviously, this meant a lot. It was emotion. That's the first part. Talk about that moment. And second, often U.S.-based teams, when Mexican teams come on the male and female side, feel like they're playing away. Mm. This is a home game for Mexican teams.
Yeah, yeah.
It was a moment of that.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
What are your thoughts about that?
Well, listen, I felt that. You know, that's why I turned around and spoke to the crowd, you know. I think for me, there was so many moments. And, you know, I think that's the thing I love about Mexican football in general, just the cultural aspect of it. Obviously, coming from London and growing up, and, you know, I never played on grass at all when I was younger. I played on concrete, so it was part of my culture. But as the game went on, as we got longer and longer into the game, we also spoke about we're from Houston, we play in this heat, we understand what it takes to play at this level, and we understand what it takes to win games in this stadium. So as I started hearing the crowd cheering and chanting our name, I just wanted to join in and make it loud, and they did that. The fans were fantastic on both sides tonight. So,
thank you, Coach.
You're welcome.
Manny, and then we'll go. Yep.
I think the main question going to this tournament: Jane, who's going to replace Jane Campbell? You show the first game with McKinney and this game with Heather. How do you know that you have two reliable goalkeepers, especially with Heather this performance today.
Yeah, I mean, look, both of them had great games. You know, Erin last week against Kansas was unbelievable as well. She made some great saves. Heather was brilliant tonight, you know. But I put all that back to our goalkeeping coach, Eric. You know, he's fantastic at providing the players with feedback and the details going into games. So I knew, and Eric knew, that whoever was going to play in these games was going to be fully prepared. And we say that, you know, we say at any given moment, if you get an opportunity to step into the starting lineup, it's all about executing. This level's all about executing. And I think both of them have done an unbelievable job for us, you know. Heather tonight made some great saves. Last week, I thought Erin was incredible in the way that we got punched in the face in the first minute, and she kept doing the things we asked her to do. That takes incredible maturity, bravery, and they're both just very, very good goalkeepers, and we're very fortunate, and we have the best goalkeeper in the world who's not here. So on that side, we're incredibly lucky.
And I know you mentioned going game by game. It seems like your attacking phase of the game has improved as well.
Mm.
Of course, goal scorers like Deanna Ordonez and Barbara Oliveri got to two goals that they needed. Mm-hmm. How much they need that boost of confidence to be coming, not only for this game, but for the rest of the season coming?
Yeah, look, listen, everyone likes the sound of the ball in the back of the net. The only people who don't like that sound are goalkeepers. So for us, it's about how do we get into goal-scoring opportunities? And we've spoken about that. I think tonight we wasn't as clean as we wanted to be, and it goes back to perhaps they played in a different way. They played a 4-2-3-1. We thought it might look, when they were pressing us, we thought it might look more like a 4-2-4. And it caused us problems. But I also think you saw moments where we broke the press really well and got forwards. But listen, we got players like Yuki, Andressa coming to the game at the end who found pockets. Cece on her return for being out so long found great spaces in the pocket. So for us, you know, we're just really fortunate right now that last week was an incredibly unique situation with illness and some injuries. And this week was more difficult for me in terms of who was going to play, who was going to start, how we were going to change the game. But they all brought into it. We said it was going to be a team game, and everyone brought into it. We don't have substitutes in our team. We have game changers. And that's what we talk about all the time, whether you're coming in to close a game or whether you're coming in to change a game. And I think you see that today from all the subs that come on the field. You're welcome.
Andres.
First half, it definitely looked like after scoring the first goal, it looked like Tigres was trying to get back into the game, of course. That was late the first half. That second half, it looked much different. It's all different scores for sure.
Mm.
That looked very composed. What do you feel like was the difference between the first half and the second half?
Yeah, I mean, I think it goes back to they played slightly differently when we were building out. So we gave the ball away and we took too many risks. There was a lot of passes that we didn't complete, and then all of a sudden the game started opening up. It became really transitional. Even on the 30th minute when Heather had a little problem, we got the group in and we said, it is way too transitional. We need to start taking care of the ball. We need to keep our shape a little bit. There was a lot of rotations because they were trying to solve problems, which is great. We talk about being brave in the way that we play, but as the game went on, especially in the first half, they started building more and more pressure, and they were serving a lot of balls from wide areas because I think that was a plan from them to put Heather under a lot of pressure. You know, and the pressure broke. It was a bit fortunate. They got a deflection with their shot, but the pressure broke. In the second half, we spoke about being brave. We spoke about trusting that we can get higher up the field, trusting that we can get to the player and get their head down and make it difficult for them. You know, and I think that's like one of the things I love about working with this team. You know, we constantly talk about the little details. How can we make it more difficult for the other team? And sometimes it's not the first press, it's the second one where we win the ball. And I think in the second half, we did that a lot more. We also never played centrally that much in the second half. There was a lot of balls played into wide areas. We knew that's where the space was going to be. And we knew the longer the game went on, that there was going to be more and more space for us. So I think those were the major differences. A little bit long-winded, but those were the major differences.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
think we have Theo on Zoom. Theo, go ahead.
I'm looking here for Zoom, right?
Straight ahead, yep.
Hey, Ricky, can you hear me?
I can hear you, Theo, yep.
Congratulations on a brilliant 3 points. Thank you for the long-winded answers as well. That was really, really good breaking it down on that one too. I want to talk a little bit more specifically about holding the ball. You kind of mentioned it a little bit, but first goal, I don't think we've seen a passing goal like that in Houston in a while. Absolutely fabulous kind of connections of play, link up. And in general, you know, like you said, second half, field tilt was great. Ball possession was great in the second half. Managed to flip overall possession from 47-53 in Tigres' favour in the first half to 53-47 in Dash's favour second half. So tell me what you maybe said in training sessions to this game and during this game to get that possession to click.
Well, to be honest, we tried to keep it really simple at half time. It was 2 points. It was basically, can we get players running in behind? So our wing backs change your angle. I felt like perhaps our wing backs were playing a little bit too high in the first half. So when our centre backs got the ball, it was more direct ball or it was a central ball, and that's where we kept losing it. So I think you saw Avery and Courtney's positioning change in the second half, and we managed to keep the ball a little bit better that way. And you know, I think one of the other things we spoke about was like runs in behind. We knew that was going to be a space that we could attack. We spoke about it in our scout during the week. In terms of keeping the ball a little bit more, we've started speaking more about tempo, and tempo meaning times we can go quick and times we can just slow the game down and move defenders with passes, and then when players move into areas where we want them to go, attacking the opposite space quicker. And I think in the second half specifically, you see that more and more. But I also think the width helped us in the second half. We knew that, again, not to sound like a broken record, but the longer the game went on, we knew there was going to be loads of space in the wide areas. And we really tried to take advantage of that. But specifically, the tempo is something we've been talking about in practice for the last 3-4 weeks, to be honest. How can we control the game, not go a million miles an hour? Because in the first half, we looked at each other and we was like, this game is 100 miles an hour. And that's not really what we wanted. We didn't want it to be like that. So we addressed it. The players solved the problem in the second half. And it looked a little bit cleaner for us, for sure.
Congratulations again. Thanks so much for your time, Ricky, and explaining
You're
that.
Welcome.
Appreciate you.
You're welcome.
All right, we'll wrap up with that one. Ricky, thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone. Appreciate it.